For Muslims, the Quran is not just a holy book. It is the very word of God, revealed to the Prophet Muhammad. It offers guidance on every aspect of life, from prayer and charity to family matters and social justice. Muslims believe its verses hold timeless truths. However, like any complex text, the Quran can be misinterpreted. It is vital to understand its verses within their full context. Ignoring this context can lead to dangerous manipulations, particularly in the realm of politics. O you who have believed, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and those in authority among you. And if you disagree over anything, refer it to Allah and the Messenger. If you should believe in Allah and the Last Day, that is the best way and best in result. This verse has been used throughout history to justify unquestioning obedience to rulers. Dictators and authoritarian regimes have often cited this verse. They use it to silence opposition and maintain their grip on power. However, the verse's true meaning is about upholding justice within a system of mutual rights and responsibilities. It emphasizes obedience to God's law above all else. Blind obedience to unjust rulers is antithetical to the Quran's message of justice and accountability. Surah Al-Baqarah 2:190. Fight in the way of Allah those who fight you, but do not transgress. Indeed, Allah does not like transgressors. This verse, often referred to as the sword verse, is used by extremist groups to justify violence and terrorism. They present it as a call to wage war against non-believers. This interpretation ignores the historical and textual context of the verse. The verse was revealed in a specific historical context of self-defense when the early Muslim community faced persecution. The Quran emphasizes that even in warfare, there are strict rules of engagement. It forbids the killing of innocents and emphasizes peace as the ultimate goal. The Quran promotes peace, justice, and understanding between all people. Surah An-Nahl 16:90. Indeed, Allah orders justice and good conduct and giving to relatives and forbids immorality and bad conduct and oppression. He admonishes you that perhaps you will be reminded. Some authoritarian regimes have twisted this verse to suppress any form of dissent or criticism. They argue that challenging their authority is akin to spreading corruption. This interpretation ignores the Quran's emphasis on enjoining good and forbidding evil. Speaking truth to power and advocating for justice are integral parts of Islamic tradition. The Quran encourages critical thinking and engagement with societal issues. It does not endorse blind obedience to authority. Surah An-Nisa 4:34. Men are the protectors and maintainers of women because Allah has made one of them to excel the other and because they spend to support them from their means. Therefore, the righteous women are devoutly obedient and guard in the husband's absence what Allah would have them guard. Often this cited to justify patriarchal interpretations of women's roles in society. This verse discusses the roles of men and women in a family structure. However, it is crucial to understand this verse within its broader context. The Quran grants women rights and recognizes their agency. Islam recognizes the inherent equality of men and women. It emphasizes mutual respect and cooperation between genders. Interpretations that promote the subjugation of women are a distortion of the Quran's message of equality and justice. Surah Al-Ma'idah, and whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then it is those who are the disbelievers. It states that judgment should be based on what God has revealed. Some Islamist groups interpret this to mean that only Islamic law should govern society. They advocate for the establishment of a theocracy. This interpretation overlooks the Quran's recognition of diverse communities and their right to self-determination. The verse emphasizes the importance of just and equitable governance. It does not prescribe a specific political model. The Quran encourages Muslims to engage with the complexities of governance in their respective contexts. Surah Ash-Shura 42:38. And those who have responded to their Lord and established prayer and whose affair is determined by consultation among themselves. This highlights the importance of consultation in decision-making. This verse states that believers conduct their affairs by consultation. This principle has significant implications for governance. The Quran emphasizes the importance of inclusivity and participatory governance. It encourages leaders to seek counsel from those they govern. This principle promotes accountability and transparency. Section 8. Beyond the headlines, the dangers of selective quotation. These examples demonstrate how easily Quranic verses can be manipulated when taken out of context. Selective quotation and misinterpretations often serve political agendas. They can be used to justify oppression, violence, and discrimination. It is essential to approach the Quran with a holistic understanding. Muslims and non-Muslims alike must be wary of those who use isolated verses to promote hatred or violence. Engaging with the Quran requires respect for its complexity and a commitment to understanding its message of justice and compassion. Section 9, Finding the True Path, Scholarship and Open Hearts. Understanding the Quran requires careful study, reflection, and guidance from qualified scholars. It is crucial to engage with the text in its original language, Arabic. Studying the historical and social context in which verses were revealed is also essential. Approaching the Quran with humility and a willingness to learn is vital. Dialogue and open discussion are essential to challenge misinterpretations and promote understanding. Education and critical thinking are the most effective ways to counter the manipulation of scripture for political gain. Section 10, Justice for All, the Quran's Enduring Message. The Quran's message is one of justice, compassion, and equality. It calls for understanding between people of all faiths. It promotes peace and cooperation. Manipulating its verses for political power contradicts its core teachings. By understanding the Quran in its entirety, we can work towards a more just and equitable world. We must strive to uphold the values of compassion, understanding, and respect that lie at the heart of Islam.